लेकिन आज हम चर्चा कर रहे हैं ऑल कार्गो लॉजिस्टिक्स के एग्जीक्यूटिव चेयरमैन शशि किरण शेट्टी जी से। शेट्टी साहब, स्वागत है आपका सीएनबीसी आवाज पर। सबसे पहले यही जानना चाहता हूं, आप अपने कारोबार के बारे में बताइए, बताइए किन वर्टिकल्स में कंपनी काम करती है और कहां से कितने रेवेन्यू आप डिराइव करते हैं?
हाँ, ऑल कार्गो इज अ लॉजिस्टिक कंपनी। वी आर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ लॉजिस्टिक एक्टिविटीज इन इंडिया एंड इंटरनेशनली। When I say in logistics, we have multiple verticals. The main vertical which contributes the highest amount of revenue is coming from what we call as LCL, consolidation and distribution business. LCL consolidation is basically moving less than container load cargo and belong to various shippers and going into multiple destinations. We load it in a container belong to the shipping companies and send them to the final destination, sometimes on a direct basis, which is always preferred, otherwise through a hub and spoke model. And we in this business have close to about 190 offices all over the world, and this is a very specialized and a very niche market, although it is a little fragmented. But it's a very specialized business, and I'm very happy to say that being an Indian listed company, we are today among the largest in the world.
जी, आपने इस सेगमेंट की बात करी, लेकिन इसके अलावा भी कंपनी कुछ सेगमेंट्स में कारोबार करती है, उसके बारे में भी बताएं।
हाँ जी, इसके अलावा what we have is container freight station and inland container depot and the warehousing business. There's a third party logistics. And also we are into project and engineering services where we do the movement of entire power plant or a refinery or an aluminium smelter or handling the windmills, solar power, cement plants. We move the cargo on behalf of the project owner from the place of manufacturing to the final destination using multiple modes of transportation, including handling the largest heavyweight packages, heavy loads, which could be as high as 700-800 tons, single pieces, which we move through the rivers and the sea and through the various roads within the country. And also we provide services to erect the plant and machinery at the project site by our own equipments. We own altogether close to about over 1,000 vehicles, which comprises of container transportation vehicles, over-dimensional handling vehicles, and then also various types of cranes up to a capacity of 750 tons. And we also have partners globally who we partner with in this business, where we share our asset and we also share the businesses with these partners. So which means the cargo originating or cargo destined to any part of the world, including America or Europe or China or other Asian countries or in Africa or in Latin America, we are in a position to move all these project-related cargo on a global basis from and to India. On top of that, we also have into coastal shipping. We currently own 3 ships, which we are running between the various Indian ports, moving the domestic cargo. These are Indian flag vessels. And only bought for the purpose of developing the emerging coastal business. We are not into.
शेखी साहब, हाल ही में आपने एक यूएस में कंपनी का भी अधिग्रहण किया था, आपसे यही समझना चाहता हूं कि वो एक्विजिशन क्या ईपीएस एक्रेटिव है, और अगर है तो क्या इमीडिएट तौर से वो ईपीएस एक्रेटिव है?
हाँ, ईपीएस एक्रेटिव तो इट विल हैपन फ्रॉम डे वन बिकॉज द कंपनी इज वेरी प्रॉफिटेबल. And we paid somewhere around $50 million for this acquisition. And the company has got 9 offices all over all the important cities in America. And they have receiving terminals, about 22 receiving terminals in spread across different parts of the US. And the company has got 350 employees. It is a company which was managed by 6 partners. And we acquired the company from them, and all the 6 partners and the other top management of the company will continue to work with us on elevated positions, and they will get integrated with our global management so that there will be a seamless seamless movement of development of the entire business in and out of them out of the United States.
Shashi saab, is acquisition ka aapko fund kis tarah se aap kar rahe hain, kyunki company ke books par humne dekha hai debt hai, kitni debt hai is samay aur cash flows kaise lag rahe hain abhi?
Yeah, a full acquisition is funded by the Belgian banks. The acquisition is done by our overseas subsidiary called Aquiline, and you know, the cash position in the company is fairly good. We have a very good cash flow. Last year we recorded an EBITDA of close to about 450 crores on a consolidated level, and you know, this year we should be somewhere in that region, because the Indian economic conditions were not favorable, as all of us know. That has you know, put some pressure on the cash flow for the current fiscal year. But overall the company is doing well. We have a consolidated debt after repayment of some of the loans which is coming up for repayment, and for that the funds have already been tied up. We will continue to have a consolidated level a debt of about 600 crore, which is roughly 0.5% of our 0.5 times our net worth of the company.
शेट्टी साहब, आप हमारे साथ बने रहिए, वक्त हो गया एक छोटे से ब्रेक का. ब्रेक के उस पार शेट्टी साहब तो ये समझेंगे कि जिस तरह से इकोनॉमी में मंदी है, काफी मुश्किल दौर से गुजर रही है, ऐसे में लॉजिस्टिक्स कारोबार पर और इनकी कंपनी पर किस तरह से असर पड़ता है. आप बने रहिए सीएनबीसी आवाज के साथ. स्वागत है आपका सीएनबीसी आवाज पर. सॉन्ग ऊपर सेंसेक्स कारोबार कर रहा है. निफ्टी में 28 अंक की बढ़त के साथ कारोबार होता हुआ नजर आ रहा है. बैंकिंग शेयर लीड करते हुए दिख रहे हैं, 2.5% ऊपर. ज्यादातर प्राइवेट सेक्टर बैंक्स कारोबार कर रहे हैं. नोयर कंपनी में हम चर्चा कर रहे हैं ऑल कार्गो लॉजिस्टिक्स के एग्जीक्यूटिव चेयरमैन शशि किरण शेट्टी जी से. शेट्टी साहब, सबसे पहले यही समझना चाहता हूँ अब आपसे कि इकॉनमी जिस तरह से मुश्किल दौर में गुजर रही है, आपके कारोबार पर किस तरह से इम्पैक्ट पड़ता हुआ नजर आ रहा है, क्योंकि हम देख रहे हैं मार्जिन्स पर लगातार दबाव है.
अभी देखिए, as far as India is concerned, the things are still not moving in a great shape. The import volumes have come down because of the currency and because of the current situation in the country. Export is likely to pick up because the rupee got severely devalued, and it made the Indian export far more competitive. So I think you know, the Indian condition, I maintain my reservation how things will shape up. It's very difficult to predict. We also have the election coming up, so it all depends on how the policy makers will create greater confidence among the investors and among the business community in general, because right now there is not much investments that is going in the Indian economy per se. Although there is some sign of the money coming back to India and to the emerging markets, so there are some improvement in the sentiments, but generally situation is still pretty much subdued. No fresh recruitments taking place, no major investments are happening. As regards the global business is concerned, as far as we are concerned, America is almost out of recession. Is growing okay, reasonably. President Obama has put a lot of emphasis on bringing manufacturing back to America to create more and more jobs in that country. So that should help the business there, and that's one of the reason we thought that, you know, it's a good time for us to acquire the company. As far as Europe is concerned, I think the initial indication is the European economy is also now getting better. is probably the recession is they come out of the recession. Southeast Asia region is okay. I think that's that business is doing well. So overall, outside India, I am pretty optimistic that things are moving well, and I am also optimistic about India in the medium term. But in the immediate term, it doesn't look all that great.
लेकिन अगर आपके नंबर्स को देखें तो साफ तौर पर दिख रहा है मार्जिन्स दबाव में रहे हैं. पहली तिमाही के ही नंबर्स देखिए, 11.5% से घटकर मार्जिन्स 9.2% पर आ गए. यहां से आगे जाकर आपको कैसा लगता है, मार्जिन सिंगल डिजिट में रहेंगे या डबल डिजिट में जाने की भी उम्मीद रखते हैं आप?
या आई थिंक द मार्जिन्स विल रिमेन अंडर प्रेशर फॉर नेक्स्ट वन एटलीस्ट द नेक्स्ट कपल ऑफ क्वार्टर्स टिल द वॉल्यूम building happens. And you know, all the one of the reason why the margins are also showing a negative growth is because a lot of assets have been created, a lot of resources have been built in the last couple of years, and those assets are not really fully getting utilized. So the focus of the company is to make those resources and those assets put into better use, so they can generate the budgeted or targeted revenue. And when those targeted revenue happens, your margins will immediately start looking up. So that's the effort that being put right now.
Shetty saab, lekin agar aapke segment wise breakup dekhen, to humne paya ki multimodal transportation operations mein kafi achhi badhat dekhne ko mil rahi hai. Kya lagta hai, ye segment yahan se aur achha kar sakta hai aage aane wali timahiyon mein?
See, as of now, I think the multimodal transportation operation will do better because of the acquisition and because of our focus as a company has gone a lot more into the international market. As far as the CFS and ICD business is concerned, as and when the volume starts gaining, so the margins will improve there. I think, you know, in the next 2-3 quarters, that's a scenario should look better. And as far as the project engineering solution is concerned, so that's there also we see a good movement of deployment of vehicles, and you know, the overall the revenue or the order book is looking somewhat better. But there is still a major problem in terms of the cash flow coming from there, because the customers are not paying the bills in time. So that is the reason you see a certain amount of stress in recovering the money. And because of that, we have to make certain provisions for doubtful debts. Although they are not doubtful, they will be fully recovered. Yes. But as a policy, any money that is due to us beyond 180 days, we make a provision for doubtful debts. So when the money gets recovered, we bring it back into the books. Hmm. So we are in our full effort to recover the money, and we are doing all the efforts to build our order book. And so that this vertical also does well going forward.
चलिए शेट्टी साहब, आप हमारे साथ बने रहिए. वक्त हो गया एक छोटे से ब्रेक का. ब्रेक के बाद लौट कर आएंगे और आपके दूसरे कारोबार के बारे में, दूसरे सेगमेंट्स के बारे में चर्चा करेंगे. आप देखते रहिए CNBC आवाज. स्वागत है आपका CNBC आवाज पर. अभी अभी आप देख सकते हैं M&M के ट्रैक्टर के बिक्री के आंकड़े भी सामने निकल कर आ चुके हैं, और इसीलिए हमने देखा है अच्छे आंकड़े आए हैं. तो 1% ऊपर ये शेयर कारोबार कर रहा है. टोटल घरेलू जो बिक्री का आंकड़ा है ट्रैक्टर सेल्स का, वो 37% बढ़त कर रहा है. इसके अलावा कुल बिक्री जो हुई है वो 22% ज़्यादा रही है. तो ये एक और अच्छा आंकड़ा निकल कर आता हुआ M&M की ओर से. हालांकि हमने देखा जो कार के सेल्स के फिगर्स आए थे वो उम्मीद के मुताबिक ही आए थे, लेकिन जो ट्रैक्टर सेल्स फिगर्स हैं वो एक्सपेक्टेशंस को बीट करते हुए नज़र आ रहे हैं, और इसीलिए हम देख रहे हैं शेयर में करीब 1% का उछाल इस समय देखने को मिल रहा है. दूसरे ऑटो शेयरों में भी आज खरीदारी देखने को मिल रही है. जिस तरह से अच्छे नंबर्स मारुति ने पेश किए हैं, और TVS मोटर ने भी बेहतरीन सेट ऑफ नंबर्स पेश किए हैं. फेस्टिवल सीजन से पहले इन्वेंट्रीज जो हैं वो पहुंच रही हैं, कंपनियों की ओर से निकल रही हैं, और इसीलिए हम देख रहे हैं कि ये अच्छे बेहतरीन आंकड़े निकल कर आ रहे हैं। लेकिन हम चर्चा कर रहे हैं ऑल कार्गो की, हमारे साथ शेट्टी साहब जुड़े हुए हैं। शेट्टी साहब, आपसे जानना चाहता हूँ कि आप कंटेनर फ्रेट स्टेशन सेगमेंट में भी कारोबार करते हैं, हमने देखा है बाल्टिक ड्राई इंडेक्स में लगातार बढ़त देखने को मिल रही है कुछ महीनों से, वहाँ से कितना इम्पैक्ट कंपनी को पड़ता है, और अगर पड़ता है तो उसको मार्जिन टर्म्स में अगर आप कैलकुलेट करके हमें बताएं तो।
Yeah, freight rate, I think it will be, according to me, it will struggle, particularly on the container side. The Baltic index is also indicating more on the bulk cargo and oil and, those kind of a commodities, where we have no much connection. Our connection is more in container freight and more in terms of the general cargo freight. So in both those categories, the freight rates will continue to remain depressed because lots of ships are still getting delivered and a lot of capacity is still coming up in the coming months and coming years. Mm-hmm. So I don't see there is a big improvement in the ocean freight that is going to take place in the next 6 to 12 months.
श्री साहब, पहले हमने देखा है कंपनी ने काफ़ी सारे एक्विजिशंस किए हैं, यहाँ से भी आगे जाकर क्या कंपनी इसी तरह के एक्विजिशंस और करती रहेगी? किसी खास स्पेसिफिक कंपनी पर आपकी नज़र है या एक्वायर करने के लिए, और कहाँ तक बातचीत चल रही है उनसे?
देखिए, एज फार एज वी आर कंसर्न एज अ कंपनी, दिस इज अवर 8th एक्विजिशन एंड अवर ग्रोथ हैज कम अ लॉट थ्रू मर्जर्स एंड एक्विजिशंस. And we will continue to look at opportunities to grow and make our company more stronger. And all the acquisitions what we have done have all been of value accretive, and they all have been managed very well. And we have now enough experience within the company to do more mergers and acquisitions. And we are extremely cautious in terms of what we are buying, why we are buying, and at what price we are buying. So we are always extremely cautious in that area, and we have a very strong management team, not only in India, internationally. We have highly motivated people, very capable people, and we consider people as a very valuable asset to the organization. We have very good systems and process in the company. We believe in a higher standard of corporate governance. We have very good board members. That's the way we are looking at, and our target is trying to achieve $1 billion revenue within the next 2 years. Mm-hmm. That's our target. I mean, it's not something we can definitely guarantee, but that's where we are moving forward. And we are also working on a couple of more acquisitions. If they work out, and the company will do even better. Mm-hmm. And we will be closer to $1 billion revenue.
श्री साहब, हमने देखा है आपने पहले बायबैक अनाउंस करके प्रमोटर्स की हिस्सेदारी भी बढ़ाई है, इस समय आपकी 72% के आसपास हिस्सेदारी है, आगे जाकर क्या मन है, क्या इसको 75% के थ्रेशोल्ड लेवल तक ले जाना चाहते हैं, और हिस्सेदारी बढ़ाने का मन है प्रमोटर्स का क्या, और किस भाव पर बढ़ाएंगे?
नहीं, अभी तो हम ऐसा कुछ नहीं सोच रहे हैं. वी थॉट दैट एट 140 रुपीज व्हेन वी डिड अ बायबैक, वी थॉट इज अ वेरी वेरी गुड वैल्यू फॉर द शेयर्स. And we wanted to also give the confidence in the market that we are buying the shares back and we believe in our organization. And we wanted to set that confidence in the market about our organization. So we have no plans to do any further creeping acquisitions or anything like that.
चलिए, धन्यवाद शेट्टी साहब आज समय निकालकर सीएनबीसी आवाज पर आने के लिए और कंपनी का आउटलुक हमसे शेयर करने के लिए. जाते आते देख लीजिए, 100.2 पर सेंसेक्स कारोबार कर रहा है और निफ्टी में भी 27 अंक की बढ़त के साथ कारोबार होता हुआ नजर आ रहा है. बैंकिंग शेयर्स में एक अच्छी खासी खरीदारी देखने को मिल रही है, रिसेंट स्टॉक्स में एक अच्छी खासी बढ़त देखने को मिल रही है. आप बने रहिए सीएनबीसी आवाज के साथ, ब्रेक के बाद लेकर आएंगे आखिरी सौदा. नमस्कार.